Hello guys, so in today's lecture we will learn about the Wumpus world, okay, and also all about the Wumpus world, like properties of Wumpus world and what are the knowledge base for the Wumpus world. So after learning this lecture you will understand how Wumpus world problems are solved and how knowledge base are made for Wumpus world. Okay, so let's start. What is Wumpus world? Okay, and why, what are the need of Wumpus world in the artificial intelligence? So let's start from the what is Wumpus world. So Wumpus world is a simple world example to illustrate the worth of knowledge base agent and to represent knowledge represent knowledge representation. And it was inspired by a video game that is Hunt the Wumpus by Georgi Yov in 1973. So the Wumpus world is a cave which has 4x4 rooms and connected with a passageway. So there is a total 16 room which are connected with each other. So we have a knowledge base agent who will go forward in this world, and the cave has room with a beast. Cave has a room with a beast which is called Wumpus, and who eat anyone who enter the room. So the Wumpus can be shot by the agent, and but the agent has a single arrow. So in the Wumpus world there are some pits room which are bottomless, and if agent fall in pits then he will be stuck there forever. So the existing thing with this cave is that in one room there is a possibility of finding a help of gold. So the agent goal is to find the gold and climb out the cave without falling into pits and eaten by wolves. So agent will get reward if he become out with gold, and he will get penalty if eaten by Wumpus or fallen pit. So guys, this is the structure of a Wumpus world. Okay. So this is a simple diagram that to represent a Wumpus world, and it is showing some room with pits and one room with Wumpus, right? And one agent at a 1-1 position, okay, at a 1-1 position, a square location of the world. Okay, so see guys, this is an agent at a 1-1 position, okay, and there are total three pits here, okay, three pits here, and here are one at the 3-1 position, Wumpus is present, right? So there are also some component which can help the agent to navigate the cave. So these component are given as following. The room adjacent to the Wumpus room are seemly, so that it would have some stench, and the room adjacent to pits has a bridge so that the agent reaches near to pits. Then he will perceive the bridge. Okay. so there will be glitter in the room if and only if the room has gold. So guys, see, only one place glitter is showing, that means that room contain the gold, right? That room contain the gold. So the Wumpas can killed by the agent if the agent is facing to it. Okay, agent is facing to it, and Wumpas will emit a horrible scream which can be heard anywhere in the cave. Okay. Next is PEAS, description of Wumpas world. So what is PEAS? So to explain the Wumpas world, we have given a PEAS description as, so P is for performance, E is for environment, A for actuator, and S for sensor. Okay. So what is performance measure? So what is performance measure? Performance measure plus 1000 reward point if the agent came out of the cave with the gold, minus 1000 point penalty for being eaten by Wumpas or falling into the pits, minus 1 for each action, and minus 10 for using an arrow. Okay. And next, the game ended if either agent die or came out of the cave. Okay. The game ended if either agent die or came out of the cave. Next is environment. Okay. So a 4:4 grid of room. The agent initially in the room square one is at position 1-1 and facing toward the right. Okay, facing towards the right. Location of Wumpas and gold are chosen randomly, except first square, that is 1-1. Okay, so each square of the cave can be pit with possibility 0.2, except the first square. Okay, except the first square. Okay. Next is actuator. Okay. So actuator, what are the actuators? It left turn, right turn, moves forward, grab, release, and shoot. And what is sensor? The agent will perceive the stench if he is in room adjacent to the Wumpas. Not diagonally, okay? Not diagonally. The agent will perceive, Brizzy if he is in the room directly adjacent to the pit, okay? An adjacent agent will perceive the glitter in the room where the gold is present. The agent will perceive the glitter in the room where the gold is present. Agent will perceive the boom, perceive the bumps if he walk into the wall. Okay. Then when the booms it shoot, it emit the booms it shoot, it emit horrible scream which can be perceived anywhere in the cave. So these percepts can be represented as a 5-element list in which we will have different indicator for each sensor. For example, if agent perceive stench or breezy but no glitter. So no bumps and no scream, then it can be represented as strange, breeze, none. Okay. So let's first understand what are the properties of Wumpas world. Okay, Wumpas world. So first property is partially observable. Next property is deterministic. Third property is sequential. Fourth property is static. Fifth property is discrete. And then last property is one agent. So let's understand what is partially observable. So the Wumpus world is partially observable because the agent can only perceive the close environment, which is an adjacent room. Okay, so what is deterministic? It is deterministic as the result and outcome of the world is already known. Okay. What is sequential? The order is important, so it is sequential. Next is static. So it is static as Wumpus and Pits are not moving. Okay. It is static as Wumpus and Pits are not moving. Okay. Discrete. The environment is discrete. Next one isn't. The environment is single. The environment is a single agent. As we have one agent, only the Wumpus is not considered as an agent. So exploring the Wumpus world. Okay. So we will explore the Wumpus world and we will determine how an agent will find its goal by applying a logical reasoning. So agent's first step is initially the agent is in first room, that is 11 square, right? And this room is safe for agent, right? This room is safe for agent. So the to represent one the below one the one this diagram that room is safe, the room is safe, we will add a symbol okay. So symbol A is used to represent agent. Symbol B is B for busy and G for glitter or gold, and V for visited room. Okay, and P is for pits, W is for Wumpus. So at room 11, agent does not feel any breezy or any stench. So which means that adjacent square are also okay. Okay. So there are two adjacent. We cannot take a diagonal here. Okay. We cannot take diagonal here. So obviously both adjacent are written as a okay. Next, in the second step, now agent need to move forward, so it will either move to 12 or 21, right? 12 or 21, because both are okay. So let's suppose agent move to room 21. Okay, agent move to room 21 at this room agent perceives some breezy. Okay, some breezy, which means Pits is around. So Pits is around this room. So Pits can be in 3-1 or 2-2, right? 3-1 or maybe 2-2. Because adjacent of 2-1 is three things: 1-1, 2-2, and 3-1. 1-1 is already visited, right? 1-1 is already visited. 2-2, 3-1. Both are they are remaining adjacent. So let's suppose agent move. So let's 2-2 and 3-1 symbol. So we will add symbol P. So we will add symbol P in 3-1 and 2-2. Okay, symbol P added symbol P at a 2-2 or 3-1. So we say that in this pit room. Okay, is this a pit room? So now agent will stop and think and will not make any harmful moves. The agent will go back to the 11 room, and the room 11 in the room 11 and 21 are visited by the agent. 21 are visited by the agent. So we will use symbol V to represent the visited square. Okay. So guys, let's understand what is third step. Okay, what is third step? So at the third step, now agent will move to the room 12. Okay, room 12, because as we know that 11 is okay, and just adjacent to the 11, 21 and 12 are present. But when first we visit 21, and we find the how many adjacent are there. So 22 and 31 are adjacent, but it find busy. So definitely it is a pit room. So it just again it's just marked 22 and 31 as a P and just return back to again 11. Okay. Now 11 because it again returned back to the 11. So 11 is marked as a visited, and now it's reached to 12. Okay, 12 because a previous second adjacent is a 12. So now 12 is also okay. So it just reached to the 12. So now agent will move through the room 12, which is okay. So in this room, 12 agent perceive a strange, which means that there must be a wombs nearby. But wombs cannot be in the room 11 as by the rule of game, and also not in 22. Okay, also not in 22 because agent has not detected any stench where it has at 21. Okay. So therefore agent inferred that Wumpus is in the room 13, and it is a current state. Okay, so there is no bridge, which means in 22 there is no pit. Okay, there is a no pit and no wombs. So so it is safe. Okay, so it is safe, and we will make it okay, and we will make it okay, and the agent move further in 22. Okay. Now for the fourth step, at the room 22, there is no strength, right? And no breezy present. So let's suppose agent decide to move to 23 at the 23 at the room 23, and at room 23 agent perceive glitter. So it should grab the gold and climb out of the cave. Okay. So guys, next topic is knowledge base for the Wumpus world. So and so as in the previous topic, we have learned about the Wumpus world and how knowledge base agent involve the world. Now in this topic, we will create a knowledge base for the Wumpus world. And we will derive some proofs for the Wumpus world using a propositional logic. So agent starts visit for first square, that is 11, and we already know that this room is safe for an agent. But to build a knowledge base for Wumpus world, we will use some rule and atomic properties. So we need a symbol, that is I comma j, for each location in the Wumpus world, and where I is for the location of row and j for location for column location. Okay. So So what is atomic properties? What is atomic atomic proposition variable of a Wumpus world? Okay. So let's Pij be true if there is a pit in the room in the room I comma j. Okay. Let Bij be the true if Bij be the true if agent perceive Brizzy in Ij. Okay. So either he will dead or alive. Next, let Wij be true if there is a Wumpus in the square that is I comma j, in a square I comma j. Let I comma j be true if agent perceives the stench in the square I comma j. So let I comma j be true if that square I comma j is visited. So let g ij be true if there is a gold, okay, and a glitter in present in a square I comma j. And let okay I comma j be true if room is safe. Okay, room is safe. So some propositional rule for the Wumpus world is R1 that is not S11 implies to not W11 conjunction not W12 conjunction not W21. Next for the R2, not S21 implies to not W11 conjunction not W21 W21 conjunction W22 W21 conjunction not W22 conjunction not W31. For R3 row not S12 not S12 implies not S12 implies W11 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 conjunction not W12 conjunction not W22 conjunction not W13. So for R1 R1 row S12 implies that W13 disjunction W12 disjunction W22 disjunction W11. Okay, so this is some propositional rule for the Wumpus world. Okay, so now understand the representation of knowledge base for the Wumpus world. Okay, so this is the simple knowledge base for Wumpus world, where an agent moves from room 11 to room 21. Okay, and guys, in this diagram you can see that three row and 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 column are made, right? Three rows and seven column are made. So here is the first row, and we have mentioned propositional variable for the 11, so which is showing that room doesn't have Wumpus, that is not W11. Okay, so obviously no stench, that is no stench means not S11, no pits means not P11, no brizzy, that is not B11, no gold, that is not G11, visited V11, and the room is safe, then okay, the room is safe, so for that okay 11. Okay, So in the second row we have mentioned prepositional variable for the room 1, 2. Okay, so which is showing that there is no wumpus stench and breezy are unknown as an agent not visited room 1, 2. No pits not visited yet and the room is safe. So in the third row we have mentioned prepositional variable of room 2, 1 and which is showing that there is no wumpus that is it written that not W21. No stands that is not S21. No pits that is not P21. Perceives breezy, so that's why it written as a B21. Okay, no glitter that's why it written as a not G21. Visited V21. Okay, and room is safe, so okay 21. So to prove that wumpus is in the room 1, 3, we can prove that wumpus is in room 1, 2 using prepositional rule which we have derived for the wumpus world and using inference rule. So apply modus ponens with not S11 and R1. So we will firstly apply modus ponens rule with the rule with the R1 which is not S11 implies to which is not S11 implies to not W11 and not W12 and not W21 and not S11 will be not S11 which give the output not W11 and not W12. Okay. So guys, see after applying the modus ponens rule that is on the not S11 implies to not W11 and not W12 and not W21, then we will get the output not W11 and not W12 and not W21. Okay. Next we apply and elimination rule. Okay. Apply and elimination rule. So after applying elimination rule to not W11 and not W12 and not W21, we will get three statements. Okay, first statement is not W11, second statement is not W12, and third statement is not W21. So after applying modus ponens to not S, after apply modus ponens to not S21 and R2. Okay, so now we will apply modus ponens to not S21. Okay, before that we apply on a S11. Now we will apply not S21 in no one not one S21 and R2. So now we will apply modus ponens to not S21 and R2, which is actually a not S21 implies not W21 and not W22 and not W31. which will gives an output as not W21 and not W22 and not W31. Okay. So this will be the output when we apply a modus ponens to not S21 and R2. Then again apply the elimination rule. Okay. So now again apply and elimination rule to not W21 and not W22 and not W31. So we will get three statements, that is not W21, not W22 and not W31. Again apply modus ponens to S12 and R1. Okay. So apply modus ponens to S12 and R4, which is S12 implies W13 or W12 or W22 or W11. So we will get the output as W13 or W12 or W11. Okay. Means this junction with the W13, W12 and W22 and W11. Here just check that here S12 when we apply S12 and R4, then here not are not written before the S12. So just check that. So that's why in the right hand side means disjunction are used as a operator. So applying modus ponens to S12 and R4, we will get the result W13 or W12 or W22 or W13. Okay. So next is apply unit resolution. Next is apply unit resolution on W13 or W12 or W22 or W11 and not W11. Okay. So after applying unit resolution formula on this and not W11, we will get W13 or W12 or W22. Okay. Next, again, we apply a unit resolution on W13 or W12 or W22 and not W22. Okay. When we apply this resolution on this, then definitely we will get W13 and W12, because see guys, when we apply end rule between these two, then what happened? W22 and not W22 will give you the false result, right? Will give you the false result, and when false is disjunct with the true value, then definitely that particular or make you can say that a false value is a disjunction with any particular value, then particular that value is actually as a result. So that's why W13 or W12 or false is given a result W13 or W12. Okay. Now again apply unit resolution on W13 or W12 and not W11. Okay. And not W11. So as an output, obviously W12 and not W12 will again give you a false result. But once it disjunct with the W13, then result will be given as a W13. So it is proof that W13 at a place W13 WUMPS is present, right? So guys, see. So see guys, today we learn about the Wumpus world, right? So what is Wumpus world? As you know that it is mainly inspired by some video game. So definitely some graphical representation are also made for this. So that's why this made as a, so guys see this in which 1-3 position Wumpus is present, and 2-3 position gold is present. Now at a 3 position pit is present. Okay, so pit is definitely whenever wherever the pit is present, adjacent room are written as a brizzy. Okay, so guys, what happened in which we assume that the square 1-1, it is safe. Okay, because agent is reside at the first time, agent is reside here, and it is safe. Okay, it assume that it is a safe. So now agent can move in a two direction, right? Either in first of all, either in the right direction or at the top. So but in this example we are taking that it is actually facing in the facing at the right side, right? So definitely it will first move to one direction, right? It will first move to one direction. Okay, so it have a two option, right? It have a two option. Either he can either agent can go at a 2-1 direction or 1-2 direction. So definitely at first it goes to the 2-1 direction. So let's understand. See, at first it goes to the 2-1 direction because at 1-1 position it doesn't it have only two adjacent, that is 1-2 and 2-1. So right now it found that the 1-2 and 2-1 both are okay, so that's why it written as a okay. And now it's moved to the first 2-1 direction, and when it reached to the 2-1 direction it found that some brizzy. So now point is because it might be 2-2 and 3-1, either maybe both, and maybe any one of them contain a pit, right? So see guys, in the diagram actually 3-1 at a pit. Okay, so that's why he doesn't know whether 3-1 contain the pit or 2-2 contain the pit. So it just mark as both as a pit. Okay, so maybe here maybe a pit or here maybe a pit. Okay, so now it's again come back at the position 1-1 and mark 1-1 as a visited, and now it again reached to the 1-2. So once it reached to the 1-2, it checked that it find that some stench. So stench means definitely it's near some wombs is present. So as 2-1 already visit 2-2 and it mark as a pit here. Okay, so guys, as you know that according to the rule, either any side pit is present. So definitely when it on the point 1-1 or 2, it have two adjacent, a one maybe a means both wombs and pits both are not lies at the same time, right? So definitely it find that the position 1-3 it have a wombs, and this position that is 2-2 it is definitely okay, because it doesn't it can't go anywhere. So that's why it understand that then definitely it will be okay. So now it's a mark as a okay at 2-2 position. Okay, now it's again reached to the 2-2 position. Now it have a two option, either he can go in the right side or right side, that is 3-2 position, or maybe 2-3 position. So, for example, it goes to the 2-3 position, and once it reached to the 2-3 position, so it found the goal. So, guys, it again come back and get a prize that is plus 1,000 points. Okay. So, guys, see, Wumpus World is actually a mainly a. game based solution, right? So before that, when we create a Wumpus World production rule or a knowledge base, before that video game is actually launched. So on the basis of that, this knowledge base and all the things are made according to them. Okay. So today we will learn about the what is Wumpus World, what are the PEAS description of the Wumpus World, that is performance, environment, actuator and sensor. Okay, and how these actually works, how what are the performance measure and what are the environments and what are the actuator we provide in this, and what are the sensors. Okay, what are the sensors present for the agent. Next we learn about the Wumpus World properties. What are the properties of the Wumpus World, that is partially observable, deterministic, sequential, static, discrete, and one agent. Next we explore the how Wumpus World actually work. How Wumpus World actually work. After that we learn how we represent the knowledge base, how we represent a knowledge base for Wumpus World. Okay, so there are some properties, some atomic proposition variable for the Wumpus World, and also some these are some propositional rule for the Wumpus World. Okay, for each row, that is R1, R2, R3 and R4. Okay, for each row there are some properties are present, some propositional rule, you can say that some propositional rules are present for this. Next is the representation of knowledge for a Wumpus World, how we represent actually a Wumpus World. So for each row we found each and every variable value. Okay, for each row, for example, for row one whether it is Wumps are present at that position, whether it is stretch are present at that position, whether any pits are present, whether any breezy are present, whether any glitter are present, whether it is okay, whether it is visited. So obviously glitter, breezy, pits and stretch and Wumpus, these all are not present at the position 1-1. So that's why it's before that negation operator are written, and in a visited V11 and OK11 is written, because this position is okay and it is visited. Okay, that's why it is written. So this is a representation on knowledge base for the Wumpus World. Next we prove that that the room 1-3 have a Wumpus, right? So by using a modus ponens rule, we actually finally we proved that yes, at the position 1-3, Wumpus is present. Okay. So now these are some homework for you guys. First learn this chapter properly and do this homework. Okay. Okay, guys, this is an book which is written by the Rich and Knight. Guys, in the excuse me, in this book, there are so many other examples are also present. So you can learn from that, and also you can exercise and just find the solution for that exercise. Okay. Thank you.